Andrew Whitworth back here in the program. How you been, Andrew?
I'm doing good, Rich. Appreciate you having me on, man.
You bet, always. What'd you do on your bye week?
You know what? We called it a prep week, Rich. It wasn't a bye week.
Okay.
It was a prep week.
What does that mean?
It was more about honestly getting ourselves ready and prepared physically and mentally for this week. I mean, so it's less about getting away and getting a break like you have in season. And I really thought we treated it really well. It was kind of a off a couple days and then the rest of the time working, you know, not necessarily like getting out on the field and practicing, but, you know, working out and doing some study of ourselves throughout the season and things that we did good or bad and what we can do better, really to be as efficient as we need to be in the playoffs.
Do you watch football at all to, I guess, scout who's coming your way potentially?
Oh, yeah. Watched all the games and just kind of know a little bit about everybody that may be in the future that you're going to have to play. And obviously it all starts this week with the Dallas Cowboys.
Before we turn to that, I'll turn you into part of the paparazzi here, Andrew. Which performance surprised you the most for what you watched this weekend?
I think that honestly a lot of the games went pretty similar to how I thought. I thought that, you know, Baltimore, I don't know, for some reason I kind of thought they might be able to repeat their performance being at home and how dominant they were. And you know, really they did play good on defense, just didn't find enough offensively to win the game. But that was one, as good as I think the Chargers are, I think they're really special. I just thought that Baltimore has kind of some of that playoff that you've seen win, just good defense, great running game. You kind of see that win this time of year, especially at home. And that one kind of somewhat, I thought they would be a little better earlier in the game than they were.
Well, and then it's just maybe, again, it's just so difficult for a first-timer to win a playoff game at the quarterback position. And as you know, last year, with Atlanta coming in last year to Los Angeles and what was able to be done to the offense that we hadn't seen very much out of your Rams offense last year, and Jared Goff. I mean, what is it about a first-time playoff experience, Andrew, do you think?
I think, you know what, I think for everybody, not just the quarterback, it's that, you know what, the efficiency level, really just making sure you don't make mistakes that put yourself behind the sticks and really hurting your football team has got to be something that you understand in playoff football. Both teams are great. You know, you're not going to get the gimme bomb plays and just, you know, kind of embarrassing each other. You're going to have to earn every yard in playoff football. And so, you know, really that efficiency of doing the little things really well is what you have to do to win playoff games. And you see it. I mean, you saw the way Indy went into Houston and just the efficiency they had in the first half. I mean, just every time they had the ball, finding a way to get that first down. And then the big plays will come eventually. And so, you know, I think that's the thing. I think that's something we all learned from last year together as a group and Jared as well. And I think we all look forward to this opportunity coming up.
Four-time Pro Bowler Andrew Whitworth, offensive tackle here on the Rich Eisen Show. The sense that Goff is not the same quarterback since that night when you guys were on tilt against the Chiefs on Monday Night Football. What is something different about him? Has something been different from your perspective, Andrew?
No, I really feel like, you know what, the quarterback wears it all. So if you're winning and you're rolling, the quarterback's going to get all the praise in the world. And if you have a bad stretch where you lose two games in a row, the quarterback's going to take the heat. And you know what, I think it truly is about all 11. And yeah, I mean, there's some plays and situations that Jared would love to have back. But also I think that we've helped put him in some of those situations where maybe we're in a situation where a big play has to be made and he's forcing the ball or makes the decision because we're not playing well enough around him. So, you know, I think it really goes hand in hand. It's everybody on offense, man. It always has been. Sometimes you can have a dominant defensive player that makes the defense good, but offensively, you know, the all 11 is going to come into factor and eventually that's going to matter more than anything else. And so I think for us these last couple weeks, we've gotten back to doing what we do well, and that's being efficient as crap all across the field and guys just doing their jobs and doing it well. And Jared has played, you know, how we expect him to play. And I think that we got to do that. We got to play well around him and give him the opportunity to be confident and go make those plays because people forget he's still an extremely young quarterback in this league with a ton of talent. And we got to continue to put him in opportunities to go be successful.
And obviously a balanced offense is a way to help that situation out. C.J. Anderson came in last 2 weeks and was just fantastic. How is Gurley looking in your estimation,
good.
Andrew?
You know, Todd's excited, and you can tell he's feeling better. And we look forward to having him back. I mean, he's a dominant football player and somebody that's really special in the huddle and just on the field. I mean, he's you know, his mentality and his positivity carries over to guys. And so, you know, I think that we look forward to having him back. But, man, what a job CJ's done. And we've really found kind of, you know, something special there with him and our mix. We just, the marriage of him and us and our running game has really been well this last couple of weeks and looks good. And I hope we can continue that. And, you know, it, I think we feel good about where we are and really, you know, the opportunity we have in front of us. So, you know, it's funny, you lose two games, and I told somebody the other day, you know, we're 13-3 and feeling bad about ourselves. It's a bad thing to be. So, you know what, these last 2 weeks we've kind of got back to being us, and the defense is playing well. We're looking forward to our opportunity.
And the sense that Zeke's coming to town, an offensive line that gets a lot of praise, is what sort of pride is on the line with you and Gurley and the rest of your teammates on the line, knowing that Dallas is coming in with that sort of credit being given on that front?
Well, you know, I think that that's something that those guys in past years earned and had a really special group. And I think that there's a lot of good football players over there. And Zeke is obviously a really special one. And so, you know what, we know they're going to play well and do their thing. But we believe in ourselves, and we were willing to bet on ourselves. I think we look forward to this matchup. We look forward to the opportunity to find out a way to win. And that's what playoff football is about. It's not about stats. It's not about big plays and who's this or that. It's about what team, you know, finds the efficiency through 60 minutes to find a way to win the game. And I think that's the only focus we have, is what's going to get us a victory. And I look forward to it. I'll tell you what, we're excited. And I think this is a neat opportunity. First time in 13 years I've had a bye week. So I look forward to feeling good and playing in a game.
No kidding. First time in a baker's dozen years for prep week, though, right, Andrew? Prep week.
Yeah, prep week, not okay. A bye week.
Don't you get any problem. Come on now. I've got your back, just like you're used to having people's backs. I understand that. What challenge does Dallas present?
Well, I mean, obviously, we've seen them these last 6-7 weeks. That defense has just continued to seem better and better every week. And, you know, I think that up front, it's similar team to probably Philadelphia a little bit, and the fact that they got a lot of great rushers, they got a lot of guys that can rotate in there, that can rush the quarterback and try and play coverage behind it and make you check the ball down and those kind of things. And they've done a really good job of shifting and moving and being able to stop the run game with those guys at the same time. And I think that their defense is going to be, you know, obviously with some really good athletes at linebacker, a tough team to have the day you want. But I think that, you know what, we look forward to that challenge. I mean, if this is playoff football, what you ought to expect is the best challenge you've had all year, and I think we expect nothing less.
Andrew, you know, I mean, congrats, by the way, on being named Walter Payton Man of the Year nominee for your team. That's pretty huge stuff, man. And, you know, we talked last time we spoke. It was prior to where it looked like you were going to play in Mexico, and then it didn't when so much was going on here locally. How is everything in the community there in Thousand Oaks just a few weeks later, Andrew?
You know, things are improving. I mean, I think that there's still a lot of emphasis on what we can do with the fires and really everything else that's happened. And so I think that, you know, that's a process for us that guys off the field in their off time are still having an opportunity to do stuff with. I mean, Jared himself has been busy with that and finding ways to raise money and to just try and help people out in this time. So I think that's something we'll continue to deal with. And, you know, for the time being, and having been through Hurricane Katrina when I was at LSU my senior year, I kind of know that process. I mean, it's just, you know, there's the immediate people that kind of react. And then there's, hey, you know what, there's still a lot of work left to do to help people out that are going through adversity. So we're going to stick in there and do everything we can as athletes to try and help our communities. We look forward to that challenge as well. But you know what? It's fun, man, to get to see opportunities in adversity sometimes, to find the bright part. Just seeing how the people pull together and seeing how people step up for one another, man, it just reminds you what's so precious about life and also amazing.
You're a good man, sir. You're a good man. Good luck to you this weekend. Congrats on making it through your prep week and getting ready for the Cowboys.
Hey, I appreciate it, Rich.
You got it.
Have a great week.
Same to you, Andrew Whitworth, at AWhitworth77 on Twitter.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on Audience.